friends. Welcome back to the Creative Discovery Museum. My name is Haven and I'm a museum educator here. And today on Kitchen Chemistry, we are gonna be doing an experiment called Drink It Caliente. So what we'll need are 3 cups, 3 tea bags, and then we're gonna fill each one with different temperatures of water. So for the first one, we're gonna fill it with hot water, the second, room temperature water, and the third, cold water. And then we're gonna put our tea bags in and see what happens in the different temperatures. So after you've placed them all inside, we're gonna wait 1 to 2 minutes and see what happens next. All right, it's been 30 seconds, so let's check in and see what's happened. We're looking at them, our hot water, it's pretty brown, and then in our room temperature water, it's a little bit yellow, and then in our cold water, it's still pretty clear. So let's wait another 30 seconds and see what changes. So our tea has now been steeping for 1 minute, and if we take a look in our hot, it looks like the color has pretty uniform dispersion, so it's brown all the way through. And then if we look at our room temperature one, it seems like the color is concentrated at the bottom where it's a deeper yellow, and at the top it's a little bit lighter. And then in our cold, it doesn't look like anything has really changed. All right, so it's been another 30 seconds, and looking at this, it doesn't look like there's been too many changes, so we can go ahead and stop our experiment there and start with our observations. If we're looking at these, we can see that it's remained about the same. And have you guys been thinking about why that might have been? Well, if we look at them again, we can see that our hot water was the most successful while our tea was steeping. And that is because hydrogen and oxygen, which are made up of water, are bonded very tightly because of the opposite polarity of the molecule. So they really want to stick together. Well, when the water is heated up, our molecules start moving around a lot quicker, and that leaves more space for our tea to make its way through into our water and disperse. And that is why it was more successful in our hot water than it was in our cold, which still hasn't made much of a change since we first started. I hope you guys enjoyed this experiment on kitchen chemistry. And we'll see you next time.